great sounds of yesterday and the best of today. 104.8 Biggles FM.
A very good morning to you from Biggles FM. Welcome along to the breakfast show. It looks like being a great day. I'll be keeping you up to date with the travel and traffic for our local area, Biggleswade, Potton and Sandy. But to get started, this is Billy J. Kramer and the Dakotas. Do you want to know a secret?
Listen, do you want to know a secret? Do you promise not to tell? Whoa, 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 closer. Let me whisper in your ear.
Biggles FM actually started after a visit to Clacton one day where an RSL, a restricted service licence station, was going on the pier. When I got back, I contacted the radio authority, as it used to be then, before it was Ofcom, and spoke to a chap and found out what we needed to do to get one of these RSL licences. And it turns out that you can only broadcast for 1 month at a time, and you can actually do 2 months in a whole year, but they have to be split by about 4 months. So this first broadcast in 2002 to coincide with the Biggleswade Carnival was financed from local companies, local businesses, and I just went round to them and said, well, we're doing a broadcast to the local area, Biggleswade, Potton, Sandy. Are you interested in helping us, supporting us? And to my surprise, they did. So we launched the station, and we were broadcasting from what can only be described now as a kind of a hayloft in the town centre in Biggleswade. We thought, well, let's have a go at this. We've been broadcasting. Let's have a go and apply for a licence. And that was where all the work, the main work, started.
104.8 Biggles FM.
9 minutes past midday, 104.8 Biggles FM. Good afternoon to you. It's Steve Dean with you through until 2 this afternoon. And I have to say, it really is a pleasure and a privilege being part of the first day of the permanent programming from Biggles FM.
Good luck with the station. It's a very, very exciting prospect.
And it's very interesting to see the setup and to congratulate you on your first day. With your new arrangements.
Sincere congratulations. I know it's been a hard slog, but I'm so pleased that you've reached your goals.
The idea of the station, it's a not-for-profit station. That is the main basis of the operation. It's not at all like a commercial station. Although we try to run it professionally like a commercial station, it's financially it's not run like that. We've got no shareholders or anyone like that to keep happy.
Biggles FM is really shaping up to be a great little radio station. Having had experience myself in working for bigger stations like Chiltern Radio when it was on the air covering the whole of Hearts, Beds, Bucks and parts of Northamptonshire, it was really difficult to actually cover the whole patch successfully. With a station this size, it's compact, it's neat and it's efficient.
Biggles FM is very successful and I feel that we come into the homes and people want us there.
If I'm talking about the weather's rotten and I was up at Asda in Biggleswade this morning, I think people like that. It sort of connects with them. So it's that whole true local feeling.
I feel that we've got some wonderful listeners. They really appreciate the job that we do. And I really enjoy doing the job.
People give their services as volunteers. They do shows. We have volunteers throughout the day and evening. And weekends, of course, and we're dependent on volunteers, and our volunteers are very reliable. You have to be reliable. You can't suddenly phone in one day and say, oh, I don't think I'll bother today. You have to be very dependable, and we have a great team here.
I think Biggles FM really aims to be entertaining, play great music, and it's a music policy which people seem to like a lot, especially the demographic, as they call it, the age group of 30+, which I suppose is what we're aiming for mainly, although obviously anybody who tunes in is more than welcome. But what is also great is that we're able to actually air the views of the community and be in touch with local events.
Sunshine, Happy birthday, Lucy, from Bill and all of us here at 104.8 Biggles FM.
The listeners are growing, of course, that needs to happen. They're growing all the time and we're getting more and more involved with the community, with outside broadcasts, and not only that, we have the community come to us if they've got something that they want to promote. People come in and they'll have a chat and we can publicise their local event. It's all about community spirit.
Wendy, the Biggleswade Eastern development is coming along quite nicely now, and when you come into Biggleswade or come out of Biggleswade, I must admit it looks nice, doesn't it?
I think it is moving now. Probably not as fast as we would like, but it is moving. And, you know, we keep up to date with meetings with the developers on, as a town council now, on various issues.
Is this going to be a very big Tesco's store in Sandy?
No, it isn't. It isn't going to be huge. It's going to be a large store, but not enormous, not a superstore really.
In Potton, as a result of the enhancement of the town centre, more cleaning has to be done of the equipment we have there. There are other premises that council owns which have to be looked after, and over the years more and more has had to be done. It has to be paid for.
Do you still write letters?
Yes, A5.
Oh really?
To those who don't know what A5 is, A5 is half the size of A4.
Yeah.
And therefore you can't put too much on a single page.
My favourite part of what I do here, and it's great with the show that I do that we get it, is the interaction with the audience, the ability to say something like, you know, tell me about what childhood TV program you'd like to bring back, or what sweet you'd like to see back on the shelves again, and then to get people responding to that.
I think it's great fun to be out there and interact with the people. I think they really accept us, they like us, they like the station, and hopefully we'll turn them around to listen to Biggles FM.
Oh, so with us right now is Kevin Wakefield. Kevin,
we showcase on the programme quite a lot of local talent, musicians, poets, artists, those kind of people. And we're starting to get quite a lot of attention from local people now. Whereas initially we used to go out and approach them and ask them to come onto the show, we're getting people contacting us and saying, can we come on? And I think that's really good, the ability to actually not only be a local broadcaster, talk to your listener locally, but also to perhaps help other people with skills and talents showcase and develop those. That would be good to do.
Well, the thing about Biggles FM is it's up against a lot of competition. There are a lot of major radio networks that people tune into, and of course local radio stations which aren't really local at all but pretend to be. And I think people are beginning to be aware of that, and that's why they come to Biggles FM. Not because it's superbly professional and has really big names, but because it keeps them informed and entertained, and it's unpretentious.
I like a challenge, and this has certainly been a challenge, and I suppose we've followed the steps, the natural progression of being on the air for a limited period to a full-time station. That's really what we've achieved that. So as long as things are running smoothly, I'm happy. Yeah.